Good evening, Kirit Sanghvi sir, and thank you very much for joining me for this
evening.
This evening, sir. Thank you.
It's my privilege. It's my privilege.
Right, sir. Sir, you had been very senior most advocate in the Junagadh district and mostly practicing in the civil side. Sir, if you can tell us, how was your journey from childhood days till you have chosen this profession?
In fact, my childhood from a very nearby village, Vadar.
Right.
I studied up to 12th in Vadar. And as far as the law profession is concerned, when I joined LLB courses, I had no idea to become an advocate. Mm-hmm. Because I was studying MSc, my MSc, after completion of my graduation in science, I started my studying in MSc with chemistry as a drug specialist.
Right.
But part-time I started studying law. So law was never my ambition at the very initial stages. Law was just a spare-time business, spare-time profession. But after post-graduating in MSc, my family insisted that you should move to the Bombay because you will get the job only in Bombay. But as far as the Bombay's past life is concerned, I always disliked Bombay. So I said, I don't want to go to the Bombay. So what was the alternative? So I joined the bar. I decided that now I have no alternative but to join at bar. So when I was in third year's LLB, I joined at the bar with my senior.
Right.
So it was not my hobby or an interest, but it was my way of compulsion.
Right, sir. After joining your law, when have you started attending courts?
When I was in third law.
Okay.
When I was in third law, I started my practice with my senior, Mr. D.L. Bithani, at Junagadh. And I used to attend the court when I was a third year student.
Mm-hmm. Right, sir. Sir, after your completion of law, how have you started your professional career?
So I joined, as I said, it was my way of compulsion for me to be here at Junagadh. If I want to be in Junagadh, I have opted for legal professions. I have joined my senior advocate, Mr. D.L. Bithani Sahib, was also there related to me. Then I started my practice as a junior. And I have my juniorship for 12 years with my seniors. I studied so many cases with him. I have also conducted so many cases of my senior also. I have argued so many cases of my senior also. So when I was, I have started my independent practice, I was purely matured. I have no difficulty in handling the cases because 12 years juniorship is a long spell of life.
Right, sir. Sir, which college have you graduated your law from? And how was the legal education then, sir?
My law college was a local law college at Junagadh, Commerce and Law College, Junagadh.
Right.
And as far as the legal education is concerned, I must say, with all my emphasis, it is the worst education as far as the Saurashtra is concerned. I don't say about Ahmedabad, Baroda or Surat because I have never seen a law college in that cities. But as far as the Saurashtra is concerned, law college is the worst. And I will cite one example. There was a big employment fair in Junagadh, government fair.
Uh-huh.
I was interviewing four students, law students.
Uh-huh.
As an advocate, I was interviewing for retaining as juniors. So that was a drama of the government, as you know it. What was important is I interviewed four students. I asked all five questions to all law students, either they were studying the first law or second law or final law. Five questions. What is the difference between Central Act and State Act?
Right.
First question. Right. Second, name one of the Central Act.
Right.
Third, name one of these local act.
Right.
Fourth question is, give me the name of any legislation of act which helps the women.
Right.
And fifth question was, what is your favorite subject in law?
Right. Right.
But it was it with your astonished event, none was able to reply. None was able to reply. So I called vice chancellor of the university.
Uh-huh.
In presence of vice chancellor, I interviewed.
Right.
This is your legal education. This is your legal education. You are a vice chancellor of a university. This is law college is under you. These students are studying in your this law college. They do not know what is the difference between state act and legal act, central act and state act. They do not know. They do not know even the subject in which they can say anything. I just put a question. Give me any subject in which I can ask you question.
Right.
One lady asked me. One lady said to me human rights. Mm-hmm. How you define legal right, human rights?
Mm-hmm.
That I do not know. That I do not know. Then how you can say that it is your favorite subject? So this is the legal education in Saurashtra. And now, after that interview, I decided my mind to file a PIL in Gujarat High Court.
Mm-hmm.
But as you know, before filing of the PIL, so many representations are required. So many information is to be collected. So I applied in by way of RTI application in so many colleges of the Saurashtra. This is pertaining to Saurashtra only.
Right.
Junagadh, Gondal, Porbandar, etc.
Right.
Sir, with surprise, I get a RTI reply from one college having a 350 students of 3 years, first, second, and third. Mm-hmm. Only one principal. Principals teaches law of contract, principal teaches constitution of India, principal teaches transfer of property. One in another college, and that is Junagadh College, in which I have studied, only two lecturers,
uh-huh.
300. So this is, there is no infrastructure.
Mm.
And nobody first, I would ask the muster roll of the colleges, how many students are attending. In fact, law was a part-time business here. Nobody is taking seriously. If you cannot get any job, you join the law college. That is the system here. So I asked him muster roll of students. How many students? You see 350 students are studying in first, second, and third law. You give me the muster roll.
Yeah.
Because I know most of them are servicing in government job or private job.
Correct.
None of them college supplied me muster roll, citing section 8 of the RTI that it is a personal matter. Though it is not a personal matter, they have never supplied because they are unable to give me a muster roll because they have never have an attendance of any students.
Correct.
If you make a surprise visit to any law college in Saurashtra, nobody studying.
Oh.
Even some of the advocates when I have started to practice is one of the some of the advocates were saying that you are my student. I don't know you.
Mm-hmm.
Where you have studied me? I do not know. But this is the position of the law education in Saurashtra.
Okay. Right, sir. Oh, sir. Sir, what changes do you propose to be made in such a type of legal education system in Saurashtra? What are your suggestions to be for the improvising the situation?
Most of the law colleges are not as per the standard provided of the UGC. First, there is no academic staff as shown in the syllabus of the UGC. So there should be an infrastructure. There is no provision for moot court in any of the college.
Mm.
And in most of the even villages, there is a law college.
Mm.
There is a law college in Una. There is a law college of Girgadda also. Girgadda and Una distance between these two is only 8 kilometers.
Mm.
So they are unable to produce good advocates because of insufficient infrastructure.
Right.
No academic qualified staff. Why they are not? I do not know why they are not recruiting academic qualified staff.
Mm.
Because LLM and doctorate is a must for a permanent employee, permanent lecturer. Because nobody selects it.
Right.
So it requires a drastic change.
Mm.
Drastic change.
Right.
And nobody inspected. I also told to the vice chancellor, why are you giving permission to this such type of low college?
Right.
Who has no infrastructure? Because infrastructure is provided under the university UGC's guidelines. They should have their own building. They should have their qualified staffs. They should have their own libraries. Nothing is provided in the low college.
Right, sir. Sorry, states of affairs are in the Saurashtra, I must say that.
Yeah, very good. Very good.
Sir, what were the striking qualities of your senior that you would like to, that you had adopted within you, inculcated within you?
My senior was Mr. D.L. Mikhan sir, was a renowned civil practitioner in Junagadh. His quality is punctuality of preparation, punctuality in case preparation. He always prepares case by his own handwriting. Second quality is which I like it, which I am also practicing nowadays, the drafting of plain written statement of any accounts of pleadings or case, always in presence of the client.
Right.
Always in presence of the client. Because if you are drafting a civil suit for specific performance, then description of the lead is must as per the civil procedure code.
Correct.
Four corners of the lead is to be shown.
Right.
When we will write from the document, document, sale deed. But sale deed will be of 1958.
Right.
Then all four corners of the lead will be changed. So if a client will be present, you will say what is your or northern side of your lead. So presence of the client is very much necessary at the time of drafting all the pleading. Maybe a plain, like a written statement, maybe a criminal missile application under section 125 also.
Correct.
It is very important. Correct. Because even because drafting of 125 is very trifling as far as our advocates are concerned. I always write when Sasu Nostrasato, Nanak Nostrasato. When that lady was sitting there, they say, oh sir, I have no Nanak. Oh, okay, then delete it. Oh, presence of the client, but I want to put emphasis that client. Presence of the client is very much necessary.
Right.
And what second quality of my senior was that he gives a free hand to handle the cases, which most of the senior do not.
Correct.
Because we have argued so many cases, even in the appellate court also, we have taken the deposition of the clients, we have taken the instruction of the clients, we have drafted the plaint, written statement, criminal misconduct application, etc.
Right.
So it's a good quality of a senior.
Right, sir. Sir, when have you became independent, and how difficult was it you to become independent after having shelter of such a great senior?
In fact, I was junior up to 12 years.
Yes, sir.
I have handled so many cases, so many even contested cases of my senior. So
right.
When I started my practice in 1989, I have no difficulty in handling my briefs, initial briefs, because I was always ready with all the matters when I was in my juniorship. So I have no difficulty as another junior sir.
Right. Sir, when have you appeared before the court for the first time, and were you nervous then?
It's you are right. Not nervous when I started my own practice, but nervous when my senior has handed over me independent certain cases. You yes. Handle the cases.
Any stage when you appear for the first time?
Yeah, yeah. When I was taking the deposition of plaintiff, it was a money shoot, simple money shoot of 25,000 for that.
Right.
So I took the deposition, but I was unable to refer the documents to get it exhibited.
Right.
So my at the evening, my senior said, have you completed the deposition? I said, okay. Whether all the documents are exhibited? I say, I do not know. I have referred it, but I have not got it exhibited. So my senior said, this is a very grave error on your part. So you correct it. Second day, I have given an application for exhibiting the document, and it was exhibited. So on that day, I was somewhat nervous.
Right. Right, sir. Sir, how difficult was it you to become independent? I mean, to get your own matters and to start with the practice.
Definitely, independent practice is somewhat difficulty, because if you will drive a car, it is a difficult. It is altogether different thing, and getting nearby driver, it is also difficult. It is somewhat different. So certain difficulties has to be faced, because not only to conduct the case, but to accept the brief, to have a brief, because somebody has to trust you, because advocacy is a profession of trust.
Correct.
Somebody at least should trust me. This person can handle this, new boy can handle this case. Then they trust. So at least 1-2 years we have a difficulty in obtaining the briefs, conducting the cases also. Because when I was conducting as a junior, I was confident that if there is a mistake, my senior will correct it.
Correct.
But now I have to correct myself. So it's at least 1-2 years, 2 years, I have certain difficulties.
Right. Sir, what are different milestones that can be, that is, that are part of your career?
I can cite so many cases, but due to the proximity of the time, I will cite only 2 examples, which please. I consider as my milestone.
Please.
When I started my independent practice, I was always search for plug the opportunity. I was always trying to pluck the opportunity. Well, I can get the publicity, when I can get the briefs, when I can come to the contact with good clients, reputed clients, politicians, office bearers of the municipality, etc.
Right.
So I was always in search of such type of cases.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what happened in Junagadh municipality, law confidence motion against the president was passed.
Okay.
By opposition. But it was stayed by civil court, ex parte.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking of 1990, etc. So it was stayed by civil court. So all the members, opposition members, will search for a good advocates. But right. Good advocates are always charging handsome fees.
Right.
So they were in opposition. They were unable to pay the handsome fees. So right. One of my friend who was a corporator, contacted me, will you accept the brief? I saw it. Yeah, generally, civil court should not stay the no confidence motion which is passed by majority. So I accept the brief. They gave me the typing charges only.
Right.
They gave me the typing charges only. I accept the brief.
Right.
Against the ex parte order of stay, I prefer an appeal from order to the district court Junagadh.
Right.
After prolonged legal matters, it was order of the lower court was set aside.
Right.
It was matter was carried out to the High Court. High Court confirmed the order of the district court, Junagadh. Now what happens? After the passing of the no confidence motion, my clients are coming into ruling party.
Yes, sir.
There are so many landmark cases which I can cite as my milestone. So only for 2 important cases I will like to cite it. First is a no confidence motion cases. A no confidence motion was passed against the president of the Junagadh municipality,
right,
which was stayed by the local civil court, ex parte.
Okay.
So all the opposition members were searching for a good lawyer.
Right.
But good lawyer always charges handsome fee, which they were unable to pay.
Correct.
So one of my friend, who is also a corporate, contacted me and he said, "Sir, will you accept the brief?" I said, "So they are not able to pay it, but it is a very good case, a sensational case for the city.
Right.
So I must accept the brief." So I accept the brief, and legally also I was knowing that this no confidence motion can never be stayed by the civil court.
Correct.
So ultimately, order is required to be set aside by any of the court. So I preferred a appeal from order,
right,
AO, to the district court Junagadh.
Right.
Matter was carried by way of appeal. After prolonged fight,
correct,
legal fight, order of the trial court granting stay against the no confidence motion was set aside by the district court Junagadh, and it was confirmed by the High Court. So naturally, our members, my clients, that is, came into power, ruling party, first resolution which they have passed in the municipality was to engage me as an advocate for the municipality, for which I had been a legal advocate for the municipality, and then it was converted into court person for 15 years.
Oh,
15 years I had been. So what I was put upon is you should pluck the opportunity in your advocacy.
Correct.
And I also naturally I was handsomely, and I fought so many cases, important cases on behalf of the municipality, which gives me a very wide publicity, because sensational cases also a good recipe for the media also. So they are also interested. So I was become a very popular, economically sound because of this plug the opportunity.
Right.
And second case now yes. Second case. That is also altogether different aspect. In one of the taluka court, there was a convicting judge. He always convicts. And as far as the prohibition case is concerned, there was a conviction ratio is 100%. So one of the senior advocates from that taluka contacted me. Okay, our judges is very convicting in nature. In all the prohibition cases, he convicts the accused. So I have carried out three matters. Yeah. Clients are in jail. They are unable to pay the fees. So yeah. I will give you 100 rupees. I will give you 100 rupees for three matters. Will you accept the brief? I said, okay. I filed the appeal. Naturally, stay against the sentence is normally is to be granted. It was granted. After that, stay was granted. I received 30 briefs of such type. That is a prohibition, a conviction appeal from that taluka court. I preferred all the before the district court stayed the matter. And when the board was displaced in the district court, there was a 30 my matters, 30 criminal matters. Right. So in my names, as I was a very big criminal advocate. Now, all the advocates, all the matters came to the board. What to argue? It was a conviction matter. But at that time, there was a news in the newspaper, Times of India, that sale of a fial, blood is collected from fial, is not to be from hospital, but it should be from registered medical practitioner, that name of the doctors.
Right.
I said, it is a very good. So I produced that Times of India to my district judge. My district judge said, it cannot be produced in the court. Mm. You should produce the judgment.
Right.
At that time, there was no email or Indian convert, etc. So I immediately went to the Ahmedabad. Go to the High Court, get certified copies of that judgment, produce to the court, and all the 30 appeals were allowed only on that point.
Right.
So that was my landmark judgment. And thereafter, I got so many cases from that taluka court. Mm-hmm. Until and unless that taluka was merged in another district.
Right.
So that was a landmark judgment.
Right. Sir, whom do you consider to be your ideal or mentor in your profession?
So many, but Justice N.J. Pandya was a district judge here.
Right.
Was a district judge here. Mm-hmm. He was a very role model for me. Yes, even because at very initial stage, we are unable to appear before the Sessions Court. We have no briefs. But he always gives me so many matters as amicus curiae. You just argue out the matter as amicus curiae. I will read the papers that does say. And ultimately, I have argued so many cases as amicus curiae before N.J. Pandya, who has become the High Court judges in Gujarat High Court and then Bombay High Court. So he was my role model. He always draws my weak points. Your argument was not up to the mark. You should argue like this. In 326 matters, there was ample evidence, as well ample evidence. I was unable to argue out. Then he said that this is the art of advocacy. When there is no point of argument, there is also a scope for another point also. I said, which you should ask for permission. I said, okay. I asked for permission. I applied for permission. Probation officer's report was asked for. An infant conviction under 324 was set aside. not set aside, but it was mentioned, it was maintained, and I was given a probation of offender's benefit. Right. So he was my role model.
Right. Right, sir. Anyone whom you like to attribute your success to, it be your family, your clients, your seniors?
First to my senior, Mr. D.L. Bithani, from whom I have studied ABC of the law. First, right. My senior. Second, junior municipality, which gave me so many prestige, financial also, and prestige also. So as my client, junior municipality, I had got so many publicity, so many prestige, so many contested cases I have fought it. I was in media because of this such type of cases. So it will be so many, because in advocacy, you should have also a wide public contact. So it gives me a public contact. So this is a part. And third, and last but not at least, my family, my wife, my children, from whom I was unable to donate devoted time. So I am also thankful to him because of my busy schedule. I was unable to attend as I should.
Right. Sir, how do you prepare a matter? What is the methodology do you adopt to prepare a matter?
Even after 4 decades of practice, in fact, we do not require a preparation, but at initial stage, I first understand from the client what he wants to convey and what he intends to, so what is his intention to get it, first easy. Secondly, probable defense which is to become, which I will consider, okay, what probable defense will come after filing of the suit.
Right.
Then I will concentrate on law points. Now law points is very much available online. Law suits, Indian canon, etc. So I will search from the law online also.
Right. Right, sir. Sir, did you had ever an instances where you find that the case on your hand does not have any merit? And how do you deal with such situations?
Frequently, every 7 days I refuse a brief, because when a person comes with a clear understanding, which they give us, we want to be succeed. I retain you because I want to win the case.
Right.
So after perusing the file, I have to say, hey, you have a weak case. You cannot succeed. Right. Or chances of success is very low. If you can engage me as an interpreter or any other, your chances are very low. Either you do not file in proceeding, do not appeal against the lower court's order, or you retain me. If you retain me, let me file it, take the chance, or take the platform for reconciliation, platform for compromise, etc., for which we will file it. Otherwise, we have to say to the client that there is no case at all, or there is a least chances for success in the matter. And there are so many cases in which you can predict right from the beginning, because if a husband approaches me that wife has filed maintenance petition, whether I can say, or even Ram Jethwani can say, yeah, no, if you will engage me, no maintenance order will be passed against you.
Sorry.
We have to say no maintenance order. We will try to see that either matter be compromised, or at least some lower side of the maintenance order should be passed. That's only we can do it. That's we have to see. So tell the clients very plainly.
Right, sir. You have told us that you had an opportunity to go Bombay for your further studies, but you chose to remain in Junagadh. You chose to do law. Sir, usually youngsters like to go outside their own district or own mother place where they have born. But why have you chose to remain in Junagadh and not to go to Bombay then?
As far as the Bombay's life is concerned, it's very fast life, because my 95% relatives are from Bombay. 100% relatives from my wife's is Bombay. So frequently I visited in every year, two times in the year I visit Bombay for occasions, for purchasing, shopping, etc. So there is a very hard life. we have to get the train of 325, Virar Express, etc., etc. When you will go to the any relatives places, they say when you will stay here for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, or 1 hour, because we have to get the Virar Express, etc. So that was a very fast life of the Bombay. They have no human value. And as far as the lockdown is period is concerned, now they have also considered. Even my old relatives are saying now Junagadh is enjoyable places.
Right.
And now as far as the small cities are concerned, even for Ahmedabad or Rajkot is concerned, they have some human values. If you have any difficulties, 25% will come here.
Correct.
In your offices. And in Bombay, nobody will come here.
Correct.
That is the life of Bombay. So naturally, that's my personal view. May not be correct, but that was my personal view.
Sir, what are your other hobbies that you pursue other than your profession?
In fact, I was to opt for journalism.
Uh-huh.
But my family refused that this is not a job for banyas. Banyas are meant for business only. But my interest was in journalism. So I used to write so many articles, which is published in local newspapers, in channels or news channels also. I also give interview frequently on current topics, on political topics, current cities, and some incidents are happening there. So I used to write articles. I also started my books named as my experience with Pramukh Swami, my divine experience with Pramukh Swami, because I had met so many times with Pramukh Swami. I had so many experiences, so many very, very nice experience with him, because he was a great saint, which I considered as a good.
Right.
So I am not a Sannyasana Swaminarayan, but I am also a Jain, but still I had met so many times to Pramukh Swami, and I have come to the conclusion that he is nothing except lower than God. So I had so many divine experiences of Pramukh Swami. So I started by writing the books. When I got a time, I write a chapter of my experience.
Right. Sir, how are you utilizing your time during this lockdown period?
In lockdown period, it was the best period for me. It was the best period. First, I can devote my time to my wife, my children.
Right.
Otherwise, all the time they were complaining that you are always busy, because I was always busy. My work schedule is from 8 to 11 at office, 12 to 6, 12 to 5, co-court, and after 7 to 11:30 in office. So I go to the sleep at 12 p.m. at night.
Mm-hmm.
So naturally, I was unable to devote my time to my family. So this was a golden period for me. Now my wife also says that you are a very good husband. And I was, but because the lack of time, I was unable to express my feelings. So naturally, and second thing is concerned that there are so many cases which requires a prompt attention in the office also, because we are always behind the new cases. Old cases we are not attending. So always clients are complaining that you are not attending the cases, old cases. So I have decided that I will argue out all the cases. I have made the preparation of all the cases from all the files. So my all office files are complete now and ready. I can argue out at any time. I can take the deposition at any time. All the written arguments of all the appeals are ready.
Right. Excellent, sir. Sir, any message that you would like to give to the legal fraternity at this stage?
As far as my colleague juniors are concerned, I must say that you concentrate on your profession first. Second, as far as the 5 years of the practice is concerned, you will earn nothing. You will earn nothing.
Correct.
After 5 to 10 years, you will have an income as you work it.
Right.
After 20 years, handsome income. There will be handsome income. So you concentrate on your profession without considering that what income you have made.
Correct.
Secondly, so many advocates criticize the legal profession. I always appreciate it. Legal profession is the best profession of the professions, because even collector salutes you.
True.
Even higher officers salutes you if they note that you are an advocate. Legal profession has a respectable status in the society.
Yes.
So never criticize your profession.
True.
Concentrate on profession. And thirdly, which I have again said in my earlier part, that pluck the opportunity. When clients comes, then you take the briefs from him, irrespective of that whether he is unable to pay or not. I have got so many cases in which nothing, even typing charges were not paid, even my initial stages. Even at this stage also, I have to do it this thing. And secondly, if you are an advocate, having some good practice, then do some social work. Social work by way of your advocacy.
Right.
Suppose I am an advocate. I am an advocate for so many institutions, namely Panjrapo, Shishu Mangal, etc. When I opted to join as a trustee in that institution, I always say, yeah, I am an advocate. I will not interfere in the internal management of the institution. I will handle only your legal matters. In Panjrapur, I will never go to the town. Makar Sankranti say, Kauda Vajav, I do not like it. But Panjrapur's house or Panjrapur's premises, after due process of law, if I am able to vacate it, it can easily say that I have donated 20 lakh rupees, because otherwise I have to be able to pay the pagaris of 20 lakh rupees to the tenant. So my legal tenant, I got evicted the tenant or trespasser, etc. So some legal, some social work is to be done, and some public work is to be done by advocates.
Right.
As far as myself is concerned, when I was in my middle order, that is not at the peak of my career yet now, but when I was completed 20 years of practice, I just watched that there are so many vehicles, government vehicles, in which red beacon lights are fitted.
Yes.
Even 20-point program officer of the panchayat,
yes,
is also fit such lights.
Correct.
So I started under the motor vehicle, about 16 office bearers.
Mm-hmm.
16 office bearers are entitled for beacon lights, red light.
Correct.
From president to chairman of the election commission, Supreme Court, High Court, etc. Only 16.
Correct. So,
as far as if there is a meeting in the collector office, I always count how many vehicles are fitted with the red light beacons. 20, yeah. 50, 57. Even Sachivali, when I go to Sachivali, there are so many. So I ask for certain information by our party application. They have also replied me, only 16 office bearers are there. So I filed a petition before the Honorable High Court.
Right.
And Honorable High Court has passed the order to remove the light,
right,
even from the sessions judges also, family judges also, all this. And now it was implemented in all India. So that is a social obligation, a social responsibility of all to do certain things which we can do only by way of our legal knowledge.
Correct.
I am running an NGO known as One Man Army.
Correct.
So I myself is One Man Army. I myself is the president. I myself is a director. So I do all these types of works when I see that there is some injustice in the society.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose, second example, mm-hmm, in Navratri.
Mm-hmm.
In Navratri, I do not know yet Ahmedabad or Baroda. As far as Saurashtra is concerned,
mm-hmm,
this Garba took place up to 2, 3 or 4 a.m.
Correct.
Up to the morning also.
Correct.
It's a social impact was very bad made, because a lady, a girl went to the Garba, Navratri Mahotsav.
Right.
Comes after 2 a.m. Rat ka 12 baje, and says his parents, Garba was going on.
Correct.
In fact, it was my motive that it should be stopped. But This is a social obligation or social commitment. We cannot file a petition for this. So I filed a petition in the Gujarat High Court.
Right.
That noise pollution, because of the noise pollution, mic should be stopped after 12 as per the law.
Correct.
And court has passed the order. Court has passed the order. So it was, in fact, it was a legal effect that all these garbas are stopped after 12. But what I put in social impact was that all the girls are safe now. Now, girls cannot say that up to 12, 2 p.m., 2 a.m., the garba was continuing.
Correct.
So it was very safe for girls also. So these are this type of social work we are doing by way of advocates. When consumer matters, consumer court started, consumer act came into existence in India.
Correct.
Consumer courts were started. It was established, but was not started. So in government of Gujarat, 18 lakhs rupees expenditure by way of the staff salary, rent of the premises were to be bought. But nothing, no case was filed because there was no infrastructure, no proper staff was there. So I filed a petition before the Honorable Gujarat High Court. Justice V.C. Patel has ordered to start immediately the consumer court, and it was started. So these are the social work which we can do it. So every junior should not only from economic side, but they should serve the society by virtue of this type of social work.
Very true. Sir, what changes do you foresee after this lockdown period in the profession?
After the lockdown period, as far as the economic condition of the juniors are concerned, it is worst, I must say. Those who are practicing from 1 year to 5 to 7 years, they are worst. But it is inevitable. Nobody can blame anyone. But as far as the lockdown period is concerned for juniors, they have a very much time for studying the law. They should study. They should consult the advocate. They should consult their seniors. Because these are the problems for me. I want to succeed in the matter. I want to argue the matters. Give me the suggestions. Give me this citations, judicial authority, etc. So this is a very time for preparation of the briefs.
Correct.
For them.
Right.
Except the devotion of time to the family, which we have said it, that is a must for it. But preparation of all the matters is a fundamental for, and preparation of law, because most of the advocates, junior advocates, were started practice without sitting with the seniors. They started the practice. They do not know the law points. They do not know the law points.
Correct.
Clients come in, they fill up the bail bond, place before the court. Court passes the order. Clients are released on bail. They accept the 100 or 200 rupees only. These are types of practice most of the junior advocates on criminal side are practicing. They should concentrate on that, how practice should be enriched by certain higher type of cases, not on prohibition cases. You, if you are a criminal lawyer, you can also take the brief of 302, 376, other cases, also cases. So they have to search the case law very, from as far as the now is concerned, computer is very much helpful to them. They may attend the seminars, because webinar is important for every junior. They can attend the seminars of legal matters. They can gather their knowledge from them. So this is the time for enrich their knowledge.
Right, sir. Thank you very much, Singhvi sir.
Thank you.
Excellent talking with you, Girish Singhvi sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.